In Westchester County today, as the state's Republican Party kicked off the election season with its nominating convention in Rybrook. And sharing the spotlight, President Obama, who spoke just a few miles away. Joining us now, our political analyst, New York Post state editor, Fred Dicker. And Fred, it's not every day that a state GOP convention is sort of upstaged by a presidential visit.
You think maybe there was some intention behind that? I mean, the governor, Governor Cuomo, had a role, obviously, in arranging for the president to be there to see the Tappan Zee Bridge construction project. By the way, there was an incident there. Rob Astorino, the Republican candidate for governor, who's the Westchester County executive, was invited. And when he showed up, he was invited to sit in the front row, his aides say. And as he was walking there, the Astorino aides say Larry Schwartz, the governor's secretary, arranged for him to be ousted and moved to the back where he had to stand. So politics really reared its face, you could call it its ugly head if you want, at this event. But the Republican convention is underway. No surprises there. Two candidates nominated today for attorney general and controller. Tomorrow it'll be candidates for governor and the new candidate just picked for lieutenant governor.
All right. And we've talked about, you know, bounces and bumps and all of that. What comes out of a convention like this? I mean, especially one that's low key in a state that's largely Democratic.
And no surprise. I mean, if there had been a surprise, maybe there would be a bounce. I don't think there's going to be any bounce at all. The unexpected certainly could happen, but the same thing probably is true with the governor's convention, which will be next week. I mean, we know he's going to be picked as governor. It depends who he picks, maybe for lieutenant governor, to see the interest there. I was kind of surprised. I don't know if you noticed it too, but here was Rob Astorino picking the first African American ever to be on a statewide GOP ticket, a sheriff from upstate New York, Chemung County, and it got virtually no play in the New York City press. I don't think the New York Times had a word about it in print. Somehow, I think if the governor picks, say, a gay running mate, that would be on the front page of the New York Times and some other publications. I think it does reflect a bias, and it points to the difficulty Rob Astorino is going to have in mounting a campaign.
And Fred, how about the ticket itself? Is it strong?
Well, it's not strong. As you noted, this is a heavily Democratic state. That said, Rob Astorino is turning out to be a surprisingly good candidate, a very aggressive one. He's been able to get some news, make some headlines. But the rest of the ticket, John Cahill, who was former Governor Pataki's counsel and chief of staff, doesn't look like he has any funds at all. And the controller candidate for the Republicans, somebody really nobody's ever heard of outside of the Onondaga area. In fact, I have to look up his name. It's right in front of me. It's Robert Antonacci.
Yes.
Yeah, the Onondaga County controller. I think neither Cahill nor Antonacci does have much of a chance. Astorino, at least he's really fighting, and he does have a chance. He's got the base of Westchester County, and he's kind of well-known in the New York City area. Cahill is an unknown throughout the state, and Antonacci is just known in central New York. So I think they're the ones that are the longest shots for the Republicans.
All right. Well, we'll have more to talk about tomorrow when we get our first look at the sheriff who would be lieutenant governor. Thank you so much for being with us today. And Fred, of course, on the radio, live from the state capitol weekday mornings, 10 to 11 on Talk 1300 AM.